So Yogi Berra had it wrong. He said, the future ain't what it used to be, because on the topic of audio over IP, the future is very bright. AOIP facilities cost less, they're faster to build, easier to build, and they really simplify workflows. So AES67 as a standard was ratified in 2013. At that point in time, a standard was created to be able to interoperate or to be able to share audio between facilities. And that's what AES67 is all about. Before AES67, using LiveWire, our clients were able to interchange audio, control, and other program associated data, as well as advertising information very easily. So in a LiveWire facility, it's very easy for our customers to be able to find sources, to be able to listen to them, to be able to feed them, and also to be able to have GPIO and advertising information as a part of the network. LiveWire customers were able to interchange audio and advertising information, control data, and also program associated data from day one of installing an AXIA system. But not every manufacturer had that capability. So what AES67 does is allows gear from our company, for instance, the Telos Alliance, to share audio information with gear from other manufacturers. And not only that, but it actually gets better because AES70 has been just ratified, and AES70 allows, for the first time ever, a standard to exist to exchange GPIO. So we all know broadcasters need closures. Broadcasters need to start and stop equipment. And that's what AES70 allows for the first time, to have an AES standard that defines how that's done. There'll be some time before that is available in gear. The standard is literally, you know, at the time of this taping, very new, but it's coming. And so that makes AES67 and AOIP an even more valuable resource for broadcasters. So today, for the first time, you're able to build a broadcast facility from microphone all the way to the transmission processor in fully AOIP. And that's the first time that we've been able to do that. Literally from microphone to the final processor. Even speakers now are equipped with audio over IP connections. So being at the front end, we've worked with partners, we've worked with customers, and we've also worked with competitors. So we have a really good view of what's coming. Here are a few things that we see in AOIP's future. More adoption across a number of different markets. It's not just broadcast now that is interested in AOIP. And we've even seen a manufacturer that's not well known in broadcasting, Audinate, with their Dante standard, now adopt AES67. We think more choices for broadcasters are better. Through organizations like the Media Networking Alliance and the Alliance for IP Media Solutions, forward-looking broadcast manufacturers are helping to speed the adoption. So Telos is involved in both organizations to help move our industry forward. We're really excited about this. So people who said no to us in the early days when we first started selling AOIP now say yes. They're leaving their TDM and other proprietary solutions and adopting AOIP. The vast majority of people that we talk to every day tell us that they will not buy solutions that are not AOIP based. Clients tell us there's a real difference between AOIP throughout the network and AOIP just at the edges. AOIP is here to stay, and we're excited about it.